What's up, guys, and welcome back to Moaning. If you guys are new here, then what is up? My name is Erica. Heya, nice to meet you. And if you're into the history or the mythology of the ancient Greeks and the Romans, then this is the place for you. Oh my goodness, it's so great that you found me. So what you're gonna wanna do is hit that subscribe button and that bell icon so that you know every single time I post in the future. But let's just dive into today's topic because we're going to be continuing in our women's only series here on the channel. And we're going to be discussing Pandora. So Pandora is probably one of the most famous women from mythology. Probably. I mean, everybody's heard of Pandora and her box, correct? Yeah, we're just going to pop that bubble like right now. She never had a box in mythology, okay? We're going to be going through that whole myth today. She had a jar in ancient Greece, in the OG myths, in the original myths. The girl had a jar, and then at some point in like 1700s, the 1800s, I don't know, a bunch of men decided that she had a box, and for some reason, like now, she has a box, but she never had a box, ever. So, we're just gonna get rid of that. Now you guys are classicists. Now that you guys watch this channel, you're also classicists, and I'm gonna hold you accountable if the whole box thing continues in this world, okay? We need to change it. She had a jar. Got it. Anyways, the text where we find Pandora, the original text we find Pandora in, are in Hesiod. So Hesiod had two works where he mentions Pandora. One is the Theogony, which is basically like his sort of like who's who of myth, right? So the whole book is him saying, he is a god, and then they had these two kids, and then those kids did this, and then they had four more kids, you know, whatever. It's basically, he just writes all of that down in that book. And then the second one, Works and Days, just sort of expands on a couple of them. So we're gonna be going into both of those and what we see of Pandora in each of them. In Hesiod's Works and Days. What's up, dudes? Derek from the future. It is super early in the morning. I'm editing this episode for you guys, and I just noticed that I said Works and Days after saying Theogony not more than 10 seconds before this. So please, 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 please keep that in mind that I mean Hesiod's Theogony right now. I do not mean Works and Days. We'll get onto that in a hot second. So if you're gonna open your text right now, Theogony, not Works and Days, I am a dunce. He writes that Zeus, who's the king of the gods, is the one to go to Hephaestus, who is his son and the god of ironworks. He goes to Hephaestus and he's like, look, I want you to make the first mortal woman, you have to construct her, and then we're gonna put her on Earth. Like, that's the whole plan. Literally, that's all we read. And so Hephaestus just goes, yeah, sure, that sounds like fine. And he starts making up Pandora. But Pandora in this story, in this book, she does not have a name, okay? She's actually given the name of Beautiful Evil. This is before she gets the name Pandora. And by the way, I will be including the Greek, whether it's a screenshot, because I couldn't figure out how to type it, or I have figured out how to type it. You will know, I have no clue whilst filming this if I can type it or not, but it's part of the fun of making these videos, I guess. That's the term that she's given though. So when you read it, if you want to go back to Hesiod, then look for that term as opposed to looking for Pandora. Either way, Zeus actually demands that she's constructed because right before this, the myth literally right before this, is the mention of how, oh my God, what is his name? Prometheus, there we go. The guy Prometheus, how he stole fire from the gods. And Zeus obviously not happy about this. He was like, excuse you? Who do you think you are taking fire from us and giving it to the stupid mortals? And so because of that, he decides that he's going to get back at them by sending them this really beautiful and amazing woman, and that is why he has Hephaestus literally construct her to be the most perfect person. But that is all we get from Hesiod's Theogony. That's it. And then it moves on into something else. But then the Pandora myth does pick up later on in Hesiod's Works and Days. And it's in that that we go into a little bit more detail about her construction as well. So Hesiod tells us then that Pandora was structured from the earth and the water, that actually those are the two elements that are sort of like combined together, and Zeus just like put them in a bowl and mix them up and then make something pretty out of it. After she's constructed, she then gets a voice and a face to sort of like match her body, but those are the last two things that are put onto it. And then Zeus calls all the other gods to come and see this construction, because once again, she's gonna be the first mortal woman. Zeus basically is like, you guys will have to come and give her some quality that we think that a mortal woman should have. So Athena gives her like craftiness, because Athena used to be like a weaver. Used to be. I'm acting like she retired from weaving. No, okay, she was always a weaver. But yeah, so she gave her that skill. We then have Aphrodite, who made her even more beautiful than she already was. We then have Hermes come down and he gives her sort of like this like thievish attitude, you know, like he makes her basically like the fun girl. And actually it's Hermes who gives her the name Pandora. So Pandora actually means all gift. That is what it means translated from Greek. And actually that the reason why he gives her that name is because all the gods gave her some sort of mini gift. And so because of that, she is all gift. Therefore, her name is Pandora. So that's a really nice fun fact. So following on from that, Hermes is the one who then takes Pandora down and delivers her to Earth. And he actually shows up at Epimetheus's door and literally hands her to him. And it's like, here you go, here's a nice gift from Zeus. Now, one thing that you should know is that prior to this, Prometheus had words with Epimetheus, okay? Prometheus was like, dude, you should not be accepting gifts from Zeus because that guy hates me and therefore he hates you. And anytime he comes, if he's like, here's a gift, just say no. And Epimetheus was like, yeah, dude, I totally hear that. Like, no problem, I got your back. And then literally Hermes shows up with a pretty girl and Epimetheus is like, oh my God, you can totally let her into my house. That would be so great. So it just gets shot to hell, like really quickly. And then Pandora ends up showing up. You know, she's just like in the house, she's chilling. And Zeus had given her a jar, okay? This is where the jar comes into it. That she is given a jar, she's living in the house with Epimetheus, but because she's now on Earth, she then opens the jar one day, the lid to the jar, not the lid to the box. She opens the lid to the jar and all of these like bad things come out of it, okay? But this was orchestrated by Zeus. This was the whole point of why Pandora was made, to do this. She wasn't just like a random woman, she was constructed by the gods to wreak havoc. And so when she opens the jar, just everything bad comes out of it. Okay, we're talking like disease and all that kind of stuff. And Zeus had actually made sure that none of them had a voice, because that way, when all the bad things come out into the earth, like disease, if we use that example, you never know like when you're going to get sick. It's like one day you're just sick. And so it's because they didn't have a voice, because Zeus took away that feature of them so that they were scarier. And that's why we're now always like, oh, I don't know what's gonna happen. Because Zeus constructed it that way, okay? And Pandora was meant to open the jar. She was meant to let all these things out as a punishment for the fire incident, okay? So that's why this whole thing has happened. However, there is one thing that gets left back in the jar. As we all know, the one thing that Pandora manages to close the lid on is hope. And that's the end of what Hesiod writes. That's literally it. There's no aftermath, there's no nothing. We don't hear about any of that stuff. And just that you guys know, because I never have my books when I have filmed in the last like 2 years that I've had the channel, I do have my book with me off camera. But just that you guys know, okay, this is how thick both Hesiod's Theogony and Works and Days are, plus an introduction. This is literally how thin the book is. So you could literally read this in like an hour. It's not like overly academic, it's very straightforward. And these are the two works, both of them, where we get those references to Pandora. So yeah. Now, one of the things that I do really want to harp on is that actually when you read the original Greek, there is no sort of emotion of whether what Pandora did was necessarily bad or necessarily good. And I do want to harp on that because I think it's a rather interesting thing that after Hesiod, then everybody likes to sort of input their views on it. So even though Hesiod describes her as beautiful evil, which we can go into the whole like word analysis and all of that kind of stuff in regards to Pandora, when it comes to her actively letting out the bad things, Hesiod doesn't say this was a good thing or this was a bad thing that she did that. And the fact that she had hope, this was a good thing, this was a bad thing. He doesn't actually tell us that. And it's everybody after that who read that or who heard that story then imposed, oh, Pandora could have at least let hope come out of there. You know, like we have all the disease, why don't we have hope? When some people, there are schools of thought, schools of scholars, schools of classicists, who read this text and who think maybe what they were saying was that it was like, at least she held on to hope for us. She let everything out that was bad. So she wasn't holding on to disease. She wasn't holding on to any of those things. She let all of those things out, but she's holding on to hope for us, which I love that mentality. I love reading when people interpret it that way. But obviously there's the more modern and more common interpretation of the myth, which is that, you know, Pandora managed to keep hope trapped in the jar and that's why none of us have any hope. But I kind of like to see it the other way. But I think that's just an important note to know that Hesiod doesn't write that, that's a lot of people hearing what Hesiod wrote and then moving from there. But that's really it. Those are the original sources of Pandora. And then, like I said, everybody else builds on her. So you're gonna wanna remember that Pandora, first of all, starts off her whole thing not having a name and just being called Beautiful Evil. And then the name Pandora means all gifts, well, all gift, technically, because she is gifted by the gods with all of her features and all of her personality traits. So that is really everything that you need to know. Thank you guys so much for tuning in. If you have any more questions about Pandora, we do always type all of this stuff up for our website, which is www.moaninc.co.uk. You can check that out via the description below. If you guys want the source material, you guys want the passages, it's all there. If you feel like you really need to leave a comment asking a question and just wanting that stuff down there, then go ahead. I always reply to the comments. So thank you guys so much for tuning in, and we'll be seeing you next time with more of these women-only series here on Moaning. We'll see you then.